Hi and welcome to Scope Month. My name is Daniel Bogdanoff. Today is Wednesday, March 15th, which means we are going to give away another six 1000X series scopes. Normally we'd only give away five, but someone posted on Twitter a picture of the cutout at Embedded World, so we're going to give away an extra five 1000X series scopes. We're going to give away one per day, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, and then we're going to give away two in the live stream on Monday. So make sure you go over to the Keysight Oscilloscopes YouTube channel homepage and you can get a reminder for that live stream. For today's scope tip, we're going to look at the frequency response analysis capabilities on the 1000X series scopes with Johnnie Hancock. And Johnnie is actually at Embedded World with Mike Hoffman this week. So if you are there, make sure you stop by and say hi to Mike and Johnnie, snap a picture, throw it on our Facebook page. Maybe we'll post them in later videos. So we pre-recorded the tip with Johnnie last week while he was still here in Colorado Springs. Let's take a look. For today's scope tip, I've brought in Johnnie Hancock. Johnnie, come on out. Johnny's going to step up on some books here. So Johnnie, what are you here to talk about today?
We're here to talk about frequency response analysis, which is a standard feature on the G models of the 1000X series oscilloscope.
And this is kind of your brainchild, Johnnie. Like I said in the live stream, you've been pretty instrumental in making this happen.
That's true. And something went wrong in the live stream. I got the channels assigned backwards. We're going to get it right today.
Sounds good. Let's take a look.
Okay. So first of all, frequency response analysis testing gives you a different view of the performance of a circuit as opposed to traditional time domain waveforms. Shows you things in a frequency domain, and it plots gain and phase versus frequency. So V out over V in, but logarithmically, so 20 log V out over V in. So I'm going to start with the default setup, and I already have my low pass filter. It's just a simple RLC circuit connected to the output of the WaveGen. Channel 1 connected to the input, channel 2 connected to the output, which is, in this case, a bandpass filter. First, I'm going to select the Analyze menu, then select the Frequency Response Analysis. Then I could go into the Setup menu. There I get a diagram showing me basically a block. So you're testing a black box. And we have a V input, V output, plus we have to connect the generator to stimulate it at the input. We can assign which channel is channel 1, which is channel 2. I'll make sure I don't bump any knobs this time. Minimum frequency, it can go down to 20 hertz. Let's go ahead and test at the extreme, and up to 20 megahertz, we'll just leave it there. And then you can set the test amplitude. Now, sometimes that's a sensitive setting. It really depends on what you're testing. If you're testing power supplies, sometimes they can be overdriven. We're just going to use the default for this passive filter. It's not very sensitive. Now the amplitude, this is in volts peak to peak. Now most standalone frequency response analyzers or network analyzers typically have them set in either voltage RMS or dBm. So you just need to do the conversion if you're going to compare apples to apples. So we'll press the back key. And the next thing is just press Run Analysis. Now, one big advantage of the Keysight oscilloscope-based solutions is you can see the waveforms during the test. The yellow waveform is VIN, the green waveform is VOUT. It started down here, you can see it plotting gain down there close to minus 50 dB. Now, the spec is as much as approximately 80 dB. So the orange trace is the phase. Now when it completes the test, and we're about two-thirds through now, as you go up in the higher frequencies, the test runs faster and faster. It runs pretty slow down there at 20 hertz.
And it'll change based on the settings that you have for the minimum and maximum frequencies. The test time will.
That's
change.
Correct.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you start at higher frequencies, it's going to run a lot faster.
So naturally you would just test the frequencies that you care about, not necessarily run the whole spread.
So here we see the final plot. So again, you can see it started. Well, let's go ahead and use the markers. You can see there's a pair of markers, one writing the phase curve, which this shows you the phase on the right-hand scale, and the gain in dB is on the left-hand scale. Now the marker readout is down here. Now the minimum was minus 44.7 dB. And we could take it up here. We might want to lock it in around minus 3 dB if we're going to measure the bandwidth. And then we go out to the maximum. And so you can measure any gain in phase at any particular frequency. It also auto-scales the scaling of both the gain and phase plot at the completion of the test. So it's giving you optimum scaling, but you can manually change it. If I go into the chart, I could select gain scale and change that, or gain offset. And then I could do the same thing with the phase plot as well.
Awesome. Thank you very much, Johnnie.
Okay.
So the FRA is included standard with all the G models. We are really, really excited about it. Johnnie has worked really hard to make this happen. So if you like it, give Johnnie a little round of applause there. There's also a webcast that Johnnie did that you can go check if you want to learn more about measuring frequency response with oscilloscopes.
Yeah. One other thing, you may be wondering, you may be aware that the 3000X and 4000X, this guy's big brothers and sisters, also can do frequency response analysis as part of the power application. They're called power supply rejection ratio and control loop response. It is a superset of this. This is kind of a subset. It has more features. You can do amplitude profiling. You can select more points per decade for your test run. You can also get a tabular view of the results. This, you only get the plot view, which is pretty darn good for what you're paying for this particular product.
Absolutely. All right. Thanks, okay. Johnnie.
Thanks.
So if you're at Embedded World this week, go say hi to Johnnie and Mike. Also, you can check out the new blog on the Keysight Oscilloscopes blog. There's a link for that in the description. So now let's draw today's six 1000X series scopes winners. Today's winners are Daniel Newbling, Nicholas Bark, Craig Chatterton, Stephen Graff, Dan Ursu, and Zachar Jeffrey. Congratulations especially to the people named Daniel. If you've won a scope, we should be in touch with you within 6 business days. That's all for today. Make sure you subscribe to the YouTube channel. Go check out the Keysight Oscilloscopes blog. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow.
Now, Daniel, this is so easy, even a dummy like you standing here next to me could do. You may be wondering why I am almost as tall as you for the first time in my life. That's because I found a good use for those old engineering textbooks that I've had. Simplify.